You've heard me. Wait for it.
So, like, other people are AWOL, so we're just gonna have you on the show.
Yeah, so welcome to Overweight Nights Roundtable, Fought. You're gonna be... You got trapped into it. So, congratulations. So...
This is how we all get started.
It's how it all happens, you know? And, of course, we got... Hey, just got shut up. Now, but of course, it's me, Cam Sex Kitty Man. We got Mort, Nick, and we have Fought, the Panda Bastard. Who we all hate and then love at the same time. Sometimes I paint myself black so I can steal things freely. All right, Just Cause. Thanks you for that info. That's
for what?
He just said, sometimes I paint myself black so I can steal things freely.
That makes sense.
That's how the law works. That's how the law works. So, because it's completely different and fuck it, I'm going to be showing us playing Overwatch at the same time as we discuss everything because... I want to see if we can keep any sort of focus in the middle of raging.
I mean, to be fair, this is how I always record.
I mean, to be fair, you're playing Rocket League and that takes no brains.
It's true. It's true.
That's not the same thing as this.
All skill.
No balls, all skill. Wait.
Did you hear that they're working on possibly a hockey, or not a hockey, but a volleyball mode?
For what?
Rocket League.
Oh!
That's yeah, cool. Somebody went through, like, the files of the most recent update patch thing and found, like, an embedded volleyball, like, map. So that could be a thing one day.
Well, I mean, okay, I don't know if you've seen it. There's a... someone did that for Overwatch, where they would fire a Junkrat ball.
Okay.
And then you'd have two Genjis doing the reflect back and forth like badminton.
All right.
I would love to see that. Oh, someone's already Torbjorn. Do I want? I'll be Junkrat. And you get better at Junkrat. I suck at Junkrat right now.
Yeah, you just generally suck.
I mean, balls mainly.
Balls.
Okay, so what are we going to talk about today? E3. We haven't talked about E3 at all. Did you pay attention to anything E3?
Not really. I was at work.
So you
something happened with Microsoft because everybody won't shut up about it.
About Microsoft?
Yeah, like Microsoft won E3. And I think that's sarcastic. I don't know yet.
It must be. I've heard a lot of people talk about their impressions of the Sony presentation and all of the good things.
Well, okay, I mean, as far as who won, I think that the slim Xbox One is an interesting idea. But at the same time, it's like, cool, what's more impressive to me is the connectivity between PC and Xbox. The fact that they're finally saying, fine, fuck it, we'll combine market shares.
Yeah, I think those are good moves, too. Like, just kind of across the board. I think especially the ability to get a copy of, you know, the other, you know, console or PC version of the game if you buy the other. I mean, I think that's both brilliant and long overdue.
Long overdue. It's something we've all talked about for years. Oh, man, why won't they do that? That sounds awesome. That's a great idea. Never got done. That Reinhardt film was dead.
Yeah, the only one I actually watched live was the E3 presser, or sorry, the EA presser. And it was just nothing. It was just nothing. It wasn't even bad. I'm sure it would have been a good presentation if there was anything presented.
EA? I saw that one with you, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was just all FIFA. FIFA has a story mode, and that's it.
Yeah, it's like, hey, did you guys know that we own the Star Wars license? Here's all the people that might be making games. None of the games. Just like, hey, we've got this studio working on a game, and we've got this studio working on a game. And did we mention Star Wars?
Did we mention that we own Star Wars now? Because we do.
Like, hey, we've got a Star Wars game being made by BioWare, and a Star Wars game being made by, you know, whoever, and just, like, listing off different companies that are making their games, but nothing about the games. Come on, not even nothing. And then they get BioWare up there to do the Mass Effect presser, and it's, you know, basically not much of anything either. I'm not feeling great about the Mass Effect franchise right now.
I mean, is BioWare even still doing it?
Yeah, yeah. Mass Effect Andromeda coming next year, I think. But, like, I don't know what to think of it because we haven't really heard much.
I mean, it's... I feel like they just don't know what the fuck to do. I guess.
I've never really understood BioWare after the whole EA thing. Like, I don't get what they're trying to accomplish. It seems like they constantly try and reinvent the wheel. And I don't know, man. I don't get it.
You mean like Mass Effect 3?
Just in general, like, the difference between Mass Effect 1 and 2 was huge, and the difference between 2 and 3 was huge. And they changed a lot of things that didn't need to be changed, and didn't ever get the story to be cohesive enough to make any goddamn sense. And it's just so different from what I guess I got, you know, introduced to BioWare with, you know, the way KOTOR was. And, you know, Dragon Age Origins, you know, I'd rather see games more like that and less of the action-adventure-y type that they've been doing lately.
And how else are you going to compete with Call of Duty? You can't compete with Call of Duty without, you know,
I've got you. I don't care to compete with Call of Duty. I don't even remember the last Call of Duty I played. It's been so long, I don't remember.
Last one I played was Modern Warfare 2. Well, that's the last one I bought.
You remember?
I don't know. I don't really miss Call of Duty.
Come on. Okay, got the medic.
Do you have an ult to freeze one?
I used it. Riptide, ready to roll.
Well, they're after me.
Shit.
I got nobody, despite the... whatever. All right, so
what I did see though at EA that I'm really excited about though is Zelda.
I'm skeptic because I don't really give a shit about Zelda.
Man, I do though. So, like, I'm just gonna go ahead and get my hopes up a little bit.
Like, not about console Zelda. Like, I love handheld Zelda. Every handheld Zelda has been like a fucking masterpiece to me. And it's like I don't get the same feeling from console Zelda because I think they're like, so busy trying to be. They're so busy reinventing that wheel that I feel the handheld Zeldas kind of got into their groove really well in the Game Boy Color era. Like,
I mean, I definitely like the handheld Zeldas too, but I mean, I would still really love to rekindle the magic of Ocarina of Time or Wind Waker again. And Twilight Princess didn't do that for me. I never even finished Skyward Sword. Like, it just did not enthrall me at all.
Four of them on fine. Change to... Justice will be done. So, I don't know. E3 this year just was not as whelming, I guess. And I'm wondering if it's because of being jaded or not.
I don't know, I didn't feel like there were any, like, huge, like, game-changer announcements. I mean, I usually expect at least, like, one or two of those from E3. Did you go Reinhardt, too? Damn it.
I died, I'll swap.
Might as well go all Reinhardts.
I mean, maybe. A big part of it has been the fact that everyone did their announcements kind of already. Like, everyone's doing their shit outside of E3. E3 is no longer the place to do it.
Yeah, I guess it's kind of true. Kind of sad, though. Get your head down, you'll lose it. Thanks. I know, I'm pretty excited about Dishonored 2 as well. Did you ever play Dishonored?
It was good. It was really good.
Yeah, I'm excited to see what they could do with the sequel.
What I'm really excited about is the fact that, like, they want to release these new, like, 4K consoles for the PS4. I don't have a PS4 right now, so it's kind of like, maybe now I'll actually get one. Like, I'll actually give a fuck enough to buy one. I haven't so far.
Right.
I don't know, E3 just doesn't really get me going. Everyone was talking about Zelda, and it's like, cool, like, it looks interesting. Ooh, fuck, good job.
And a boy, fuck.
Hey.
But, I don't know, was there any game that you heard about, fuck, that you particularly enjoyed?
Maybe Battlefield 1?
But that's something that was already announced, you know? Like, it's so...
Yeah, but, I mean, just watching... I guess, like, watching Snoop Dogg high as hell play that game.
Dude, okay, Snoop Dogg might have won E3, okay? Fuck the company, Snoop Dogg won E3.
Without a doubt, the best presentation of E3.
I mean, like, that's the only one I actually saw, because after that, like, I had to work, like, 2 7-hour shifts at work and basically missed out on E3.
I mean, you can see the recaps.
Yeah, I went back and I saw, like, Microsoft, I guess, Forza Horizon 3. It's in Australia now, and...
That's a change of the franchise?
Yeah, that's... Everything is ass backwards now.
Oh, shit. They're measuring your speed in kilometers. Watch out. I don't know. I think that a big issue that people seem to have is that, like, again, one of my friends went to E3, and everything there, it looked like she was having a fucking blast. But to me, being like, just seeing it from the outside, it's like, this isn't that interesting. It's like, it's people trying to relate to the kids, and it's very much Steve Buscemi, like, a lot of it.
I don't know who to pick.
It's like, how do you do, fellow kids? Isn't it crazy? Or, like, it's like, ugh. Isn't it lit, guys? Are you hyped? What do you call a drunk German knight?
Reinhardt.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Quit screwing around and get ready to move, right? I don't know.
I'm always
ready. E3 just definitely didn't interest me. As weird as it sounds. And, like, what did Zeke want us to talk about?
Berserk?
Oh, yeah. Oh, Berserk. Okay. So there's a possibility that Berserk's getting
this is a different map.
What's it called? Dynasty Warriors type game. And I know you guys have never heard of... I don't know. Have you heard of Berserk?
I've heard of Berserk.
It's a good... it's a good manga, good show. And they're making movies, new movies about it now. Again, to continue the arc.
But all I know about it is what I briefly saw when I looked it up after Zeke mentioned it.
It's good. That's all I'm saying. It's bloody, it's brutal as shit. Locking down the objective. Rally to me!
shit.
Fall in here. So, I don't know. I like Dynasty Warriors. I like what they did with the Gundam, Dynasty Warriors Gundam series. So, I'm excited for any, I mean, all Dynasty Warriors related things.
And I think I've maybe played Dynasty Warriors
before. You've never played Dynasty Warriors, dude?
I think I've played it, technically.
Well, how about, like, any of the Onimusha series, right? Any of the other series that, like, are tangentially related to Dynasty Warriors?
No, not really.
Okay, well, it's a hack and slash kind of game. Kind of open world, sort of. Not really open world, but...
It's like a giant arena.
Yeah, it's a map, and you gotta control points. And a lot of the enemies and your teammates are cannon fodder, and you play as heroes within the universe, whatever it's set in. So, like,
makes sense.
With fucking Dynasty Warriors, it follows the romance of the Three Kingdoms. So it's about like. Three Chinese dynasties that.
Justice reigns
from above. And the three Chinese dynasties, it's super awesome. You play as generals. I did play the shit out of all of them. But.
Hatched up.
Dynasty, I mean, Gundam is like, you just get all the fucking different Gundam series and put them all together. And it's like, alright, cool.
Got you in my sights. Ooh, nice.
Sucks for that guy.
Yeah, I saw that, kind of.
You stupid?
Okay, so... putting that same idea with Berserk, it's like, alright, cool, so just a hack and slash, we just beat the shit out of a lot of people. And then when you take certain points, you fight certain bosses, and it's all about troop movement and, like, capture this point, route the general, route their troops, and doing it in a certain time. Like, there's kind of a, it's not even complicated, but there's quite a bit to it. It's super awesome.
Yeah, it sounds interesting.
Ow. Anyway. So, I mean, I would like to see that become a thing. I would definitely put some hours in it. Not dead
yet. What's the setting of Berserk?
It's a pseudo middle, like medieval setting.
With demons.
Say that again, Paul? Fuck.
With demons?
Yeah, with demons and fairies and shit.
Off topic, if you see those Junkrat's little, bear traps anywhere, fuck them up for me. Because they're ruining my shit.
Well,
repeatedly.
A big portion of Berserk is like this fantasy element to it. How the fuck? I'm sorry, man. Well, I don't know. I just think that E3. Didn't have any. I don't think anyone has ever talked about now is Zelda, but that's because of the nostalgia factor. I don't think it has anything to do with the fact that, like, oh man, the game looks amazing. Like, it looks okay. Like, it's interesting, but it didn't look like it's gonna make me buy a fucking console to play it.
I mean, I would for a good Zelda game in a heartbeat.
If it's good, but we've. Don't forget Twilight Princess.
I haven't.
What happened with Twilight Princess?
Not Twilight Princess, Skyward Sword. Don't forget Skyward Sword.
Yeah, I would like to. It was really not fun. I've got you in my sights. I love the smell of pulse munitions. Oh, turn it
off. And wondering what happened with it. Skyward Sword was like not well received by even fans. Like, at least that's what I.
Because it, at least for me, it was not fun. Like the control scheme was clunky and awkward and awful. And I mean, if you can even control the damn game, how are you gonna play it? Like I couldn't get into any aspect of it because I couldn't get used to just trying to play the damn game.
I mean, it makes sense. And again, I know that a lot of people did not seem to enjoy a lot of the aspects of it.
Come on, somebody take that Reinhardt down. God. Wasted damn ult on him.
My ultimate is ready. I've
got you in my sights. Yeah, I don't know. I think Nintendo got kind of cocky with the success of the Wii as a console and got lazy with the games.
Like the Wii U? I mean, they've already considered it a fucking failure. What more do you want?
I mean, the Wii, the original Wii, like, I think they got too cocky with it. I don't think they've put out a good Zelda game since the game that was designed for the GameCube and ported the Wii.
How dare you, sir. No, you're right.
I mean, Twilight Princess was pretty good. It wasn't the best, but it was, I mean, it was really solid. And then we haven't had a good Zelda game since.
That's been years, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been a minute.
I don't know, I'm just, the only thing, the games that excite me are things that were announced before E3, so. Like Battlefield 1, I want to play Battlefield 1 so bad.
Yeah, but that wasn't the E3 thing, that was already there.
Yeah, that's what's
already had it.
Yeah, the only thing they did was show off gameplay.
Like, okay, they showed Civ 6 gameplay. And that's something that I definitely am excited as shit for.
Yeah, very excited, but it wasn't exclusive to E3, so.
Yeah, again, to me personally, E3 was a bit underwhelming in terms of showing. So okay. So now that we're done with E3, because fuck E3, I guess. Like, I don't know. I'm not until I get invited. I'm not gonna give a shit.
Hint, hint.
Did you hear that, companies? Invite me, some nobody. Do it. I would love to be part of your event. I salute you. But to actually be there, not in the answer. Bryan Cranston just admitted that he's gonna be fucking Zordon.
Oh.
I mean. I'm not a young man. Yeah, it's great for him to come back. You know, after all these years, and give back to Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
I was gonna say, like, he played a lot of monsters on there, right?
Yeah, he did some villain voices, which I always thought was kind of one of those just funny, like,
trivia
facts
things
that everyone knows. But like to bring him back, and it's kind of hilarious, and I like it. I dig it. I've got you in my sights. I don't really know what to make of the movie yet, but that at least is pretty good.
With this payload, we got three down. But yeah, so I mean, Bryan Cranston is—he's a good actor. I mean, he's gonna—he and Elizabeth Banks are gonna show the fuck up like anyone who's gonna be a fucking ranger.
Yeah, like real talk. Did they even announce who they've got for that? Are they doing nobodies or what?
It seems to be nobody. I really don't know. I haven't heard anything. Not really.
Yeah, I'm not clear on any of that either.
I mean, no one's gonna talk about nobodies, really, but I mean, should they? No.
I mean, I feel like you have to go nobodies, though.
Yeah, I guess so. I just feel like it's an interesting casting for Zordon. I mean, I probably would have put him in something else than Zordon.
I don't know. It seems like a good choice. I mean, that's basically like a featuring role. Like, it's not like a headliner role, so you can get away with paying him less, but still have a big name for it. I mean, I think it's probably a good choice. I've got you in my sights. Oh, let's break it. we just kind of did okay that game. Not great.
That's how I died.
Not good. Just kind of okay.
I don't know, but are you going to watch Power Rangers? Are you excited for Elizabeth Banks' weird, like, Poison Ivy kind of costume? Me.
I have not seen anything from that movie. Power Rangers is the kind of thing that, it's like, I remember it, like, I remember having fun watching it, that I don't want to go back to it.
I mean, this is something different. I mean, it doesn't have to ruin the bullshit that was the old show. It's kind of like, I don't revisit Ronin Warriors, and I recommend anyone who watched Ronin Warriors as a kid to never watch Ronin Warriors again. Because I went back, and I regret it.
I don't think I've seen that Ronin Warriors.
Ronin Warriors was... I want to see the original Japanese, because I'm pretty sure it's got to be cool. It's got to be cool, right? I mean, it's got to be cool.
Yeah, it's got to be cool. It's Japanese.
It's Kawaii Desu. Or is this guy's name... The other guy's name was Kawaii Philo.
good.
But yeah, I mean, it was an anime about people who got magic suits of armor, and they were all about the I think they were the zodiac signs, and so their armors kind of coincided with.
So you're saying it ripped off Power Rangers?
It was part of the whatever it was called. Hero Sentai, kind of style. So yeah, this game.
No,
this was way before Power Rangers, though. But yeah,
I know that was a joke.
It was so good, and then I watched it again, and I was all like, "Oh my god, this dub is so bad."
How did I put up with this? Oh yeah, I was a child.
Oh yeah, I was like 7. Oh, that makes sense. I don't know. It seems like there's some interesting shit there.
Here, Junkrat in there.
In the Power Rangers remake. 3, 2, 1. Attackers
incoming. Defend objective A. Oh shit. There is a Winston. Oh fuck. What's he really in?
Whee!
YouTuber. What's that dude bitching about?
At the start of the game, I hit shift and charged and killed him as soon as you walked through the door.
So? Like, that's... loud?
No, I got that from YouTube. Actually...
Yeah, I scavenge YouTube for game tips.
All of my gameplay comes from YouTube. I wouldn't know how to walk if it wasn't for YouTube.
Fucking god damn it, that goddamn gorilla. Can we ban the gorilla for being invincible?
Well, I killed soldiers, so I don't know. A lot of the movies coming out recently aren't interesting to me. Is that weird? Is that a bad thing? Like...
No, I mean...
I come off as sexist if I say, like, you know, that new Ghostbusters movie looks like shit. But it does. It looks like shit. Like, remove all of the things around it. It sucks. And I haven't seen a trailer yet that's fucking excited me in a while. I need heals. Who's a healer?
Jesus.
It's a... Who's a healer? Got it. Has there been anything that has caught your interest, Unique?
As far as, like, trailers and shit go?
Movies,
not really.
Games, anything?
I'm trying to think of anything new. Like, there's plenty of stuff that's, rehash or remake or sequel or whatever, but I'm trying to think of new properties I've been excited about in a while, and I'm drawing a blank. Yeah.
How about you? You got anything interesting that you've had your eye on that you want to check out?
Uh, I can't think of anything off the top of my head right now. Other than maybe Doctor Strange, but I don't really know anything about that. I mean, there's like nothing about it other than the trailer we've already gotten.
I mean, we got Benedict Cumberbatch.
Cucumber
Biznatch playing Doctor Strange.
Cumberbund.
And he sounds exactly like fucking Dr. House, because apparently every British person trying to do a gruff American accent sounds exactly the fucking same.
Well, yeah, pretty much. You ever tried to do an American accent?
I mean... No? Considering I'm American.
Because you have one, a real one. Fuck you, Call of Duty.
I will say this, playing while trying to talk is
difficult.
It's a bit difficult.
It's difficult in a game like this because I'm so busy trying to.
God damn it. I got chased by that Winston for his entire ult.
I was trying to just catch up to him, but it didn't work out.
We're also woefully underprepared for this particular session.
Oh, I agree. But anyway, yeah, we've been gone for a while, really. It gets a
little out of practice.
Yeah, it's been one of those things where I've been working on a new project, though. Nick knows about it, definitely. We're working on a coloring book.
Yeah.
I know that sounds weird, but I definitely wanted something to have at conventions and stuff to give away, sell, yada yada yada. So we're working with a tattoo artist to put together a coloring book.
It's gonna be killer.
Oh, yeah.
For real though, like the artwork we're looking at is pretty incredible.
Yeah, I'm
really excited about it. Super, super stoked about it.
I'm trapped and can't move. Why can't I move?
Because you're...
Nick, there's somebody going up the stairwell.
Whatever, game. You piece of
shit. I don't know how to describe this area.
I heard footsteps, but I don't know where they are. Oh well.
But Overwatch, man, it's consumed my life.
It's pretty much all I'm playing right now.
It's like, thought. Opinion on the game. Tell me. You bought it twice. Tell me. Between the console and the PC players, honestly.
PC players are way better.
Way I'll better. Say
that. No joke.
Yeah. Yeah,
no joke.
And on top of that, I'm using the controller because I got frustrated with trying to learn how to play the keyboard.
Same.
So it's like, I'm just going to be a scrub. And...
That fucking pleb, dude. But you know what that means, though, right? Up. You know what that means?
No.
It means that technically we're better than they are?
No, I mean, like, when you go back to console, you're going to be, like, fucking...
Oh yeah, it's ungodly.
Like, oh, I play people who are actually good. Like, I don't know if you know this.
60 seconds.
Like, I can understand like a lot of the complaints that I'm hearing on Reddit about like Torbjorn has auto aim, and it's like, you know how awful that is when you can't aim as precisely as you can with a mouse and keyboard. Like, that's awful. To have a character that has fucking. Half second delay auto aim.
Is that where we put the teleporter? That doesn't seem like a great idea.
It really doesn't.
Oh, Winston come around. Never mind.
Team kill.
Fuck. Yeah.
Alright, anyway. But yeah, so the PTR just came out, and I don't know if you guys have tried competitive mode. Probably not.
Not yet.
Because you have to download the game essentially over again, or just copy the files from one folder to another folder.
Yeah, I've done that. I just haven't looked at it yet. I'm going to do that tonight.
It is interesting that people actually give a shit and try. And that's always nice.
They're coming down that stairwell.
Yeah, because you put your teleport in the middle of nowhere. What were you thinking? Damn, KO. I was sniping that Winston over here from afar.
Fuck. But, I don't know. I'm excited to see what competitive mode brings. The golden guns seem interesting. They don't all look great on every skin. It looks kind of crap sometimes. But
yeah, and it seems like only certain parts of the gun are just gold, like her Bastion.
Well, I mean, for Bastion, like, either his entire body is a gun, or like only the guns are guns.
But then I guess that would just be a skin.
Yeah, so I think they did the best they could on people that have built-in weapons, but
yeah, like D.Va's a
since
my
primary play is Reinhardt, I get a giant golden hammer. I like that idea.
I don't know. I just want to see more diverse, I guess, skins in the game.
Weapon skins.
Yeah, like if you're gonna start adding weapon skins, I'm okay with that. I like that idea.
I mean, more stuff to collect is more stuff to collect. Yeah, I'm all for it.
Oh, I literally charged the fucking tire. I hit the tire, it bounced up, and then it blew on the gun.
I tried to stay on that.
Oh my god. What an awful...
Crap.
Wait, how come my ultimate didn't, like, land? Okay. I hit my ultimate on Soldier 76 and it was just like, nope. Get on the pillar.
Suck my dick.
That was so close. Just like one.
Damn. Minute.
Also, so we're working on the coloring book, and double. Look at that. Oh, fuck! This is why you're not talking. Well, like, just play the games.
Oh, that dirty Reaper. It's the second time you've gotten play of the game with that same Reaper, like, move thing.
Cue of the game. I was better. Fuck you. That's salt right there.
Epic. Yay.
But yeah, so we got that comic book coming up, and on top of that, we have a. I have Michael working on some comics. He's finished a few of them. He wants to scan them and send them. That way, it's not just, you know, him using his phone to take a picture.
Yeah.
So
yeah, I had Michael do some work for me a while back. It turned out really well.
Really.
Yeah.
For oh, who's what the.
Oh, that's fair.
Yeah, for like actual shit, like I need some actual work. Yeah. Work done.
I may need to leave.
No, you don't. Fought.
Fought. You don't need to leave.
Fought, please.
Fought, please. Whoa.
Oh, okay. I guess we all left.
That wasn't fun at all.
But But
Sawyer, you tricked me.
I don't know. I think that I was trying to get my friend to play Overwatch because he is one of the best Battlefield players I think I've ever played with.
I think I've seen some of his videos.
Yeah, I'm always tagged in them. Like, he's good. Like, he's fucking good.
He's the one that runs around with the defibrillator.
The defibrillator?
Yeah.
Yeah, he'll kill people using that. Yeah, it's pretty bad. But I keep on trying to get him to play Overwatch. He's like, no. And I'm like, why not? Play Rainbow Six Siege with me. I'm like, no, I'm not going to play Rainbow Six Siege with you. Like, I'd have to buy it. And he's all like, why don't you buy Battleborn? I'm like, what?
Because I don't buy lame games.
Because it has too many MOBA factors to it, and I don't want to play it. I mean, here's the thing. Like, Titanfall had a lot of MOBA factors in it, but I wanted to, you know, support Respawn Entertainment and blah, blah, blah. Prepare to attack. But hopefully Titanfall 2 gives me what I want. Fix all the fucking problems with it. Gives me what the fuck I want. What? Give me what daddy needs.
I never played the first Titanfall. So.
It was kind of like this where it's online only. Blah, 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 blah. But the gameplay was so solid. Shot. One kill. It just, there wasn't enough people that played it. But it was just so solid. I'm like, oh. So I'm waiting for part two, which will apparently have a campaign. Oh, I guess that happened.
Oh, no, it does have a campaign.
So, that's what that's what E3 was, another announcement, right?
Yeah, actually, I completely forgot about
now
that.
Now that I think, see, that's so bad. That is so bad. That was an E3 announcement, Titanfall 2.
Well, I mean, they didn't really show that much.
They just said, by the way, part 2, campaign.
Yeah.
Buy it. You're done.
Didn't they say we're going to reveal more in the days to come?
Okay. Yeah, I guess.
Again, it's like, E3 has kind of fallen.
It's kind of like, cool, we're here because it's an obligation at this point.
Yeah.
It's like, eh. So, here's the thing I'm excited about. I know you guys should, I mean, I don't know about excited about, but it's just that I haven't played in a while. But, it's, interesting.
Okay.
For Warzone Halo 5, they just announced a new boss.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, the grunts with mechs. Grunt guy. Yeah. That's interesting. It's interesting. It's the first thing designed for Halo's Warzone specifically, right?
Besides all the wrecks, yes.
That and the weapon that they're, or the vehicle they're adding to it is only.
Oh, yeah, the whatever the thing was called. Weren't it? Maybe? I don't know. I forget things.
Oh, I'm gonna die.
Okay, I'm not doing well with her at all.
Yeah, they're doing baby's first combo. Reinhardt, Bastion, Mercy, damage boost.
I mean, it works, but whatever. Oh, let's break it!
Yep.
Bastion's down. Let's do this.
You can't stop me, homie.
Can't stop, won't stop. But I don't know. A big factor in a lot of the E3 press conferences for me has been whose ass they're kissing at the actual convention itself. A lot of the swag bags, a lot of this and that, seem to be like you have to be here to enjoy what the fuck's happening. Like, one of my friends went to a concert thanks to, like, Ubisoft or some shit, because they had a concert there, so he's like, cool.
Right.
I mean, that does nothing for me as a regular consumer or anything, really. It's just not useful. But whatever. I mean, it is what it is.
The war goes on.
We're not special yet. Yet. Give it time, maybe. But yeah, I definitely just wanted to get something done. I know we need to get back more on schedule after our little...
Fields town.
Yeah, I remember you guys were, like, doing your...
We went to the convention, to Morbius Corpus and stuff, and, like, all of us were... Now we're working on other things like, what's the word? The coloring book. We're working on getting comics made. It all takes so much fucking time.
Well, where was your convention?
It was in Corpus.
I have no idea what that is. Corpus. Sorry, people in Corpus.
USS Lexington, you know.
What?
Let's see. What is Corpus Christi? The founding place of Whataburger. I mean, like, it's a Texas thing, man. It's a.
Oh, I.
You know Whataburger, fatty.
Yeah, I ate there.
Well, Burger Place? Yeah, I know Burger Place.
Yeah, I know that. Because it was, like, right next to my apartment.
Because they're fucking everywhere in Texas, man. Like, it's not even like the fact that, oh yeah, it's a Texas thing. Like, no, it's at every fucking corner of the neighborhood thing in Texas. Like, in Corpus, because that's where it started, like, there's one on every block. Like, you can't travel further than to see a goddamn one. It's like, oh man, should we go to Whataburger? I don't know. All right, well, let's just keep driving. All right, how about Whataburger? Like, that's still an option, apparently. Like, hasn't changed.
It's still on the table. It's just two more blocks down.
It's just another block down.
We have a Whataburger, but I've never eaten there.
Oh, that's right.
It's pretty good.
That's right. It is an Alabamers.
Yeah, just, like, not a lot of them. I'd have to go, like, ridiculously out of my way.
Is it in Birmingham?
I mean, kind of.
In the area, at least?
Okay. It's in one of the mini suburbs, to the point where whether they're in Birmingham or not is kind of up for debate.
Oh, it's Birmingham.
I'm gonna kill that Pharaoh. Bastion's down. Bastion's back up.
Pharaoh's gone.
Healer's down. No. Oh, we won. Sweet. Yeah, fuck yeah. We're
level 50, and I got a reward. Play of the game. No way. Bastion of the game. Color me surprised. I've got you in my sights. Chuck your voice. Neutralized. At least that was in it. Alright, at least that was in it. I'm excited for things to come for us. Gotta get everything more refined, gotta get more stuff done. Gonna be going to South Carolina in a few weeks. And then, let's see, after that...
That's such a weird place to go.
Isn't it, though?
Like, sorry to all of our listeners in South Carolina, but that's a weird place to just go.
I mean, yeah, but I mean... Prepare your
defenses. So I mean, sometimes you just have to go to South Carolina. Fine.
I mean, so is
I've had to go to South Carolina.
A lot of people go to Corpus, too.
But I mean, what about for the people who live there?
I mean, but they don't go there, they just are there.
Is
you're
it
in
like
South Carolina, you don't go to South Carolina.
I mean, they do when they
no,
leave.
No, they're already there.
And they're like, oh, we got to go back to South Carolina.
No, once they get free, they never go back.
Maybe, just I don't know, Kitty Man was going to go there and was like, I'm kind of stuck here.
He's going to just like send us a message like, hey, I kind of like it here.
This is my life now. I'm going to throw this out there. This is my life now. I don't know. We are going to a beach resort, so it might be one of those things where it's kind of like, I don't want to leave, Daddy.
I mean, could be a cult, could be a life model decoy. We don't know. Just saying, like, things can happen in South Carolina.
Stay tuned to that Twitter feed.
Where are you building that turret, boy?
Right here. You're going to bash me up?
Hell yeah, buddy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I wish we did have a bastion here to my left. It'd be perfect.
That would be pretty killer. We just had one more part of the noob combo.
And then we need a mercy, and so we have all four over here ready to die at bullshit. Five,
four. I'll be your mercy.
We have a daisy chain of mercies. Attackers
incoming. Oh, they got a Genji.
Yay!
I'll make him my first order. Hopefully he doesn't sing.
Oh, fuck. Well, that's one way to do it. Shit. All my turrets keep dying. I'm gonna stand there while I shoot you.
Go to the right.
Oh, here they come.
My baby. No. Shit.
It gave me credit to kill Chilo before I got credit to kill Chilo's man.
Oh no.
Oh fudge.
The latter half of this is going to be pure gameplay.
We're getting some good matchups here, so, you know.
I accidentally clicked out to check something for 1 second. Yeah. Yeah. No bueno. Push on.
This is not over. Oh, Tracer on me.
I'm waiting to see what other line work he finds.
I mean, coloring book. What exactly is in this coloring book? Is it meant for kids?
It's the stuff that it's meant for convention goers. People are into nerdy shit.
Oh, there it goes.
Well, for the second time, it's clicked out for me, but not by choice. But, yeah, like, if you saw the Tracer and Junkrat that I shared on the page, there, it's that artist who's doing our shit. And he's a tattoo artist, and he's got a lot of examples of work. It's fucking amazing. I want them all to get in front of me right now, second.
Oh, they have two Genjis.
Fucking shit, yeah, they do. They do.
Well, that's cool, I guess. But I don't know. I was thinking about seeing how much art he wanted to provide. If he wanted to do not safe for work stuff, like you'd have an adult version, like an adult. adult adult version. Like one that we hide from the kids. From the kids. Oh, you hear that? He called you no skill.
I don't care. I killed him. That's why he's mad.
I wasn't even aiming at you.
They go double fair?
Yeah, they did.
Two Pharahs, two...
Two Genjis.
Yeah.
Too fast, too furious. Damn, I had a triple kill and couldn't stop them all. Just kind of missed everything.
Up, Genji. I'm happy about that.
Fucking Pharah. Multiples of any hero start to get annoying. Holy shit, I think I just saved you all. I just Reinhardted that exploding D.Va mech away from everyone. Anybody else see that?
I mean, no.
God, it was awesome.
Oh yeah, Reinhardt shit can ball that pretty well.
No, he left-shifted it. I call it left-shifting because it's the button that isn't the PC. But he charged it.
Douchebag, double Lucio.
Shit, Pharah got behind us. That might be play of the game. I'm not happy about it, but it might be.
This is just like an intense cat and mouse thing, and I don't like it.
Yeah. Did you see the I guess it was a video. I read a transcript, I think, of the multiplayer director for this game.
Jeff Kaplan?
Yeah. He put out like a lot of information about the matchmaking system and upcoming changes and all sorts of stuff. Like, I mean, it was probably the most in-depth communication I've seen between a gaming company and a community.
Yeah. Halo 5 kind of does that.
Well, Blizzard does a pretty good job.
Well, Blizzard does it pretty well.
I don't know, like, it makes me feel good about supporting the game to see them, like, trying so hard to put effort into it.
Shush, Nick, I'm trying to watch Cam suck, Kappa. Fucking Ryan, that EMG, baby. So we're talking about the game and Jeff Kaplan's interview, and... Shut up, Nick!
Yeah, that basically didn't do anything for you guys.
GG.
Oh, did you leave the game?
Normal rip. Oh, man. That was good. That was good stuff. But, yeah, I'm
sorry. Reporting.
Let's drop the beat. Die, die, die. Oh, that's because you took him out with the fucking Lucio boost, too.
Oof. Good.
Now, is that when he told you that like, you suck? Thank you.
No, I think it was a little after. Okay. No, he was Genji when I killed him because he had his ultimate and I killed him with a headshot.
No bueno, sir. No bueno.
That means you suck at Reaper, right?
Yeah.
Fuck yeah, loot box.
I don't care. I can suck all I want if it means I kill him.
Right. If it means I'm great at the game, I don't mind sucking at the game.
But back out real quick. I need to...
Oh, sure.
Back out as a team, baby! Even though I love Lee Jane Tower as Lucia. Bodie McBoat. Yep. You're too memester, sir.
Sorry, who?
EFG.
Good.
Oh. He's using all the dankest of the dank memes for
ooh, I got
Twitch,
purple.
Twitch emotes.
He is quite danker.
You left the group, but did not leave us with... Anyway, yeah, so... I don't know. I think this one is going to be one of those episodes where we're just kind of like, well, that was, you know, it was one of those days. It's a day.
You know, we did our best.
We did our best. We're doing our best. We're trying. I'll try to get more videos up ASAP.
I stand by my work.
I mean, I literally haven't... I didn't say search for a game, say back out. I wasn't like, give me a second. Jesus Christ.
Oh, my bad.
Jesus. Jesus.
Traveling to well, shit.
No, I want you to back out to start searching a game immediately.
I don't know.
Being homeless increases your dank levels. Yes, it does, Ryan. Your dank level just hits, like, epic heights. But yeah, so, I mean, yeah, we'll try to get more stuff done. Other than that, we'll hopefully get more stuff done video-wise. Today I just posted on the Facebook page... And it's the first time I posted in 11 days. I'm like, ooh, yeah, I need to get back into that.
Yep.
Yeah. You need to get stuff done. You need to get that artwork together.
Get back in the swing of things.
Yeah, get back in the swing of things. Get out of this funk. This post-con funk. Like, I'm going to start building a Reinhardt cosplay. Not a Reinhardt cosplay, my bad. A Roadhog cosplay. That's who it was going to be. and hopefully have it ready by PAX, the next PAX. I can get a tire, right? I can get a tire, put anal beads on it, you know? I mean, people will be confused, but I'll be like, dude, it's just spikes on his shoulder. They're not really anal beads, right?
I can do it once, then. Oh. If I grew my beard out, I can probably do it.
I mean, if you're coming to PAX South, I'm totally down. And I'm going to PAX West this year. I'm going to go to TwitchCon. We'll see how that goes. But other than that, we'll figure this shit out. Until then, I'm going to say thanks, Fought, for joining with us, even though, you know, you didn't even do anything. God.
I mean, I only got play of the game 3 times.
I mean, okay, you focused a lot. You got a lot of play of the game. That was pretty cool.
like every game, the exact same character, the exact same way.
I jumped in and hit Q, and I won the game. Congratulations, Fought. You are literally the best. You're literally the best.
I'm amazing. I should just retire.
You should go pro. You should go pro and make everyone love you. They'll love you. They'll be like, oh my god, Fought Senpai. And they'll get naked for you. It'll be great. You'll be signing tits and... That's what they do, right? They sign tits? Like,
pretty sure that's part of it.
It's a huge part of it. Yeah, thanks, Fought. Thanks, Nick. We'll be back next week, hopefully, with something interesting to talk about. Hopefully with Zeke. We'll see what happens. But
he's my favorite.
Is he really?
I like him.
I do, too. He makes me laugh. He's a man after my heart. He's editing a review of a game that I've never even fucking heard of. So I can't wait for him to be done with that.
I'll keep an eye on my feed.
So keep an eye on the channel. We'll see when that fucking happens. And I'm going to upload an unboxing video that we did after the Morbius Corpus Con. We opened like 4 boxes. So everyone got a box and got to open one. That was pretty fun. It was me, Stacy, Zeke, and Tony. Post day 3 of the con. Post day two of the con. Well, we're all tired after doing our second panel. It was ridiculous. It was absolutely ridiculous. But yeah, I'm definitely not going to do an outro this time. I'm just going to end it and be like, deal with it. We'll figure this out for next week.
Let it die a slow death.
Oh, and peace months. Do you notice me? Yes, peace months. Yeah, I'm gonna end this particular one. Start again. Cam, get Nick to play Legion. Okay. Also play Legion, I guess. So get WoW.
I'll buy you WoW, Nick. I'll buy you and Eric WoW.
And then get the buy Legion though. And then your subscription.
Oh, I can't do that.
Sure.
We'll see.
All those things.
We'll see. But yeah, I'm gonna end the stream and then start it up again as just a regular Overwatch, under Overwatch. That way it's, you know, just us playing games. But thanks for watching. Thanks, Fought. Thanks, Nick. And we'll have a better time next week, I believe.
Bye.